I the asshole for not having my stepdaughter in the family photo? I, 32 female, and my husband Jack, 36 male, have 3 kids together. Lydia, 5, Carol, 2, Solomon, 8. Jack has an Ephraim, 8 female, from a different marriage. It's our last week of summer before the kids start school, so we decided to rent a lovely little beach cottage for the week. It's a common theme in my family to take Christmas card photos while on vacation, so naturally I wanted to take the photos while we were away. Here's a problem. Jack is white, but Anephrine's mom is black and she turned out looking very much like her. I don't care what race she is, but my parents, however, are pretty racist. I have limited contact with them for several reasons, so they've never met Anephrine, but we're on Christmas card terms. I don't want to send them a card that Anephrine is on because they will make a fuss about the certain word with the hard R child. So my plan was to take pictures with just me, husband, and bio kids for my parents and a couple other relatives and then have her be in the picture for Jack's family and our friends. But when I called picture time and told the Nephrin she wasn't going to be in this picture but the next one, she started to look upset. I did let her take our pictures, which lifted her spirits, and we got some lovely pictures with her too. We also got some ice cream and she hasn't been upset beyond that initial moment. The trouble came later when Jack asked why I didn't want a Nephrin in the photo. He said he thought it was maybe so I could get one with all of my kids. I didn't want to lie to him, so I told him why, because I don't want Anephrine to be exposed to people who could potentially and emotionally hurt her. Just like that, he went from being understanding to pissed. And I guess he said, she didn't want you in her picture because you're black, or something like that to his daughter, and now she's upset with me too. I really wasn't trying to hurt her in any way, I did this out of care and love, but I think I might have done it in a wrong way, so am I the asshole?
Am I wrong for refusing to do the bridal party's makeup at my own wedding? I, 27 female, have been a working makeup artist since I was 18 years old. With that being said, I have always been the one that does all of my friends and family members' makeup whenever there's a special event.
Whenever I got engaged about a year and a half ago, I told everyone up front that I would not be doing makeup for my own wedding. I honestly didn't think that this would come as a shock to my friends and family, specifically my bridesmaids and my own mother. At first, I thought that they were joking when they said they would not be in my wedding unless I did their makeup for them. But as my wedding day got closer, I realized that not only were they not joking, they were actually really upset with me for refusing to do their makeup on my wedding day. Even though I love my job, it sometimes feels like I am more of a worker than a guest at my friends and family's events. Plus, I really did not want to have to work on my wedding day. I told them that they are more than welcome to hire a different makeup artist to come do their makeup for my wedding, and to that, they told me that I was being selfish and inconsiderate for asking them to spend more money on my wedding. I totally understand where they're coming from, but I had already made plenty of sacrifices in order to make this as cheap as possible for everyone involved. Growing up, I had always had a vision that all my bridesmaids would be in the same dress because I honestly think that that just looks nicer for weddings. But in order to accommodate some of the girls that I knew didn't have as much money just lying around, I told them that they could get any dress they wanted to as long as it was in the same color. It may not seem like much, but to me, this was a huge deal. At this point, I didn't really know what to do because I honestly feel like I did more than enough to make everybody feel comfortable and accommodated. They were asking me to take care of them on my big day for free, which is not something that I would normally do anyways. I decided to confide in my maid of honor about how this entire situation was really upsetting me. And I honestly thought that she would just talk the other girls into hiring a different makeup artist for the day. But instead, I was confronted via group text message by all of my bridesmaids. On the day of my wedding, I ended up feeling really guilty, and so I ended up doing my mom and my maid of honor's makeup anyways. The other girls got themselves ready, but kept making comments throughout the entire night about how I was being a total brat. I really don't feel like I did anything wrong by refusing to do their makeup on my wedding day. If anything, I feel like they owe me an apology for acting this way towards me on my special day, and not taking into consideration how stressful it would have been for me to take care of my entire bridal party's makeup, my own, and enjoy my day as a bride. After my wedding, some of my bridesmaids decided that they were going to cut off all contact with me, and even removed me from their social media. I really don't feel like it was selfish of me to tell them no about doing their makeup, but what do you think?
About a few weeks ago, I got invited to go out with some of my friends, okay? And they weren't even really, like, my friends. They're just kind of some acquaintances that I know. And they're kind of, I don't want to use the word scumbag, but some of them are a little bit on the, you know, evil side at times. And I don't really know. They don't do anything to me that's wrong, so I'm cool with them. But they invited me to go, like, driving with them, okay? They wanted me to, like, you know, get picked up by them, and we're gonna go drive around the town and do whatever we wanted to do. And they picked me up, okay? And I get in. There's already 3 people there, so it was a packed car. And we had to go and pick up this kid's girlfriend. And I don't want to say this kid's girlfriend is, you know, she's a little too outgoing sometimes, okay, in front of her boyfriend too, which is just not too cool. And he's cool with it completely. Like, most of the time they're just on fucking drugs, so they don't even know if, you know, what they're doing is wrong, so it's cool with them. I guess if that's how you want to run your relationship and it works for you, then go ahead. But it just got a little ridiculous at times. They did some fucked up shit together, and like, she can say whatever she wants to other people and he didn't even care. So we pick up this kid's girlfriend, okay, and I gotta give her a name story, okay, and she gets in and she was already on something, okay, she was was on some sort of drug. I don't know what it was, but it was making her say some shit that she usually wouldn't say, okay? So she gets in, and she's like, hey, what's up? She's hugging everyone, and, you know, she's just being nice, and that's fine. And then we get onto some other topics, and I'm just gonna jump right into it, considering I don't wanna, like, put in a bunch of backstory that doesn't matter. But we're sitting in the car driving, and we start bringing up videos on YouTube, okay? And one of them actually knows that I make videos, and he was telling them about how I made videos and stuff, and they were asking me questions about it. And it was just really cool. I love answering questions about YouTube. So after they asked me all these questions, one of my friends was like, it's so crazy that some of the people that comment on videos are so ruthless. And that just sparked a whole other conversation. And I actually talked about how certain YouTubers, you guys know who I'm talking about with this, they have people that go in their comments and say really funny, fucked up shit like fist me daddy and really weird shit like that. And that just sparked a whole other conversation. We started talking about YouTube comments, and this girl actually asked me, she was like, wait, so do they actually want to fist their favorite YouTubers? And I was like, I don't know, maybe, like, I don't think so, I just think it's a joke. She's like, that'd be so weird. I was like, yeah, it would be. I mean, fisting your favorite YouTubers isn't something that I would want to do, so, I mean, I hope no one actually wants to fist me or anyone else in that category. And she's like, that'd be weird. I was like, yeah, it would. And then my friend actually just chimes in and is like, hey, have you ever been fisted? And he said that to the girl, and I was like, oh no, dude, this is just gonna be fucking awkward from this point on. Here we go. I've never had a YouTube comment war in a car before, so let's see what happens. And we're sitting there, and my friend is just fucking with my other friend's girlfriend. He keeps saying weird shit to her, like YouTube comments and stuff. And he just goes, he's like, have you ever been fisted before? And she's like, no, I've never tried it. I almost did, but you'd have to pay me to do that. And right when she said that, everyone just kind of looked at her, and we were like, huh? And I looked at her, I was like, you would let someone pay to fist you? And she's like, well, it's $100, wouldn't you? I'm like, nah, I don't think so. But you're telling me, if I whipped out an $100 bill right now and just looked at you and was like, hey, if I give you this, can I fist you? You would be like, yeah, sure. And she did. She fist me. I was like, okay, I'm done with this. I looked the other way. My friend actually turned around, the one who's dating her, and was just like, what is wrong with you tonight? Like, what are you doing? And the whole rest of the night was super fucking awkward. And I actually decided to incorporate the Mrs. Fister joke into my everyday life with her. So every time I see her now, I'm just like, hey, Mrs. Fister, how you doing? And I fuck with her, because it's funny. But yeah, I made everything super, super awkward, and the whole rest of the night, I was just staring at my feet, repeating the word fist over and over in my head, and still haunts me to this day. But no, I'm just kidding. It was super awkward, and yeah, we just like to mess with her now about it. And we didn't even know, like, she could be the number one comment troll, like, for real. She could just fucking be the number one comment troll, and she knew everything that we were talking about and just pretending to say stuff like that. So you never know, guys. Conspiracy theories. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this really awkward story, and if you want more, leave a like, and I'm sure all the comments are just gonna be wonderful for today, so have fun down there.
I've always wanted to tell this story, but never knew how, purely because I've had to lie about the events of this night so many times. Just to make this video, I had to contact other people to get the facts straight. So yeah, this isn't a moral or anything, it is purely a story. I don't even know if it's that funny, as a matter of fact. I think it's hilarious. But anyway, sophomore year of high school, my mom had to go on a business trip overnight. And you know, being a sophomore in high school, I was like, oh shit, house to myself. But I had no friends. But a few friends I did have, one of them was a foreign exchange student from Colombia named Juan. Hello, Juan, I miss you very dearly. I hope you see this. So I invited Juan over. We bought some weed, but had absolutely nothing to smoke it out of. I didn't know how to roll at the time, I'd only just started smoking. So we took a can, like a Coke can, poked holes in it and made one of those little makeshift bong situations where you poke holes in the top, put the shweed on top of the holes and like breathe through the mouth of like the can opening. And again, I had just started smoking the shweed. So I got so fucking zooted, and we sat there for hours just like, holy fuck. Like, to this day, I'm pretty sure it might have been laced, you know? Cause it felt a little weird. But after about 3 hours of just sitting on the couch staring into space talking about absolutely nothing, he looks at me and he goes, Jamie, thick Colombian accent by the way, and I was like, what? And he was like, I want some pie, and I was like, holy shit, me too. So we hatched a plan to go to the store to get pie, but the store was too far away. My mom had a business trip overnight, so I had the car. Do not drive while intoxicated on anything. I know that now. I made bad decisions as a child, okay? Don't come for me. So we get in the car, we start driving, and thank fucking God there were no cops out that day. Because let me lay it out for you. We start driving, I'm driving down the highway, you know, watching the speedometer, and then I come to rest at a red light, and I'm like, damn, this red light is taking forever. 3 minutes go by. Then 5 minutes go by and I'm like, damn, what is going on? So then I'm like, oh, okay, like, why is this taking so long? I look around. I'm about 50 feet a fucking way from the stoplight. The stoplight is here. I am way back here. Just like, And then I'm like, oh, fuck. So then I, like, step on the gas. We made it there. We got some pies. But don't drive while smelling kids. Don't. Because I got lucky. If not, I definitely would have been arrested. And one definitely would have got sent back to Colombia.
What's the most disrespectful thing that's happened to you in the service industry? I'll go first.
I have been looking for this sound forever to finally share my truth.
So excuse the fact that I look busted right now, but it's time. So when I was in high school, I did running start and also did cheer. And so I had a lot of fees to pay, like a lot. And my parents were always so supportive of me doing it, but they were like, if you're gonna do these activities, like, you need to put in your own money, which was never a problem with me. So I decided to get a job at Starbucks. But because I had cheer and classes, I literally had, like, barely any time to work, so I'd have to work really early in the morning. But really early in the morning, we never had as many customers as we did, like, during rush hour. And so I would work in the window by myself a lot. This lady pulls up and she already just has this really negative energy to her. And I say, hi, like, good morning. Like, what can I get started for you? And she rolls her eyes. And she's like, I just need my morning coffee. And I'm like, okay, like, what exactly is your morning coffee, ma'am? And she orders a Frappuccino. I am so sorry if you love Frappuccinos, but if it is 5 o'clock in the morning and you're ordering a Frappuccino and you're a grown-ass woman, I'm gonna judge you because I am a hater before I'm a human. And I'm like, can I get anything else for you? Like, in my super annoying customer service voice. And she's like, no, but can I get a cherry on top of my Frappuccino? And I'm like, what? And she's like, a cherry. And, like, I'm like, what? And I'm like, we don't have cherries. And she just blows up. And she's like, I've been to multiple Starbucks and they've always put a cherry on top of my Frappuccino. Like, this has never been an issue. And I'm like, okay, well, we don't have them here. Sorry, queen. And she informs me that she will pull up to the window and we can solve the problem up there. And I'm like, great. See you at the window. So she just starts going off at the window and is so upset. So I pull over my manager and I'm like, hey, this lady would love a cherry on top of her Frappuccino. And my manager is like, We don't have cherries. And I'm like, of course we don't, because this isn't fucking Sonic. This is Starbucks. And so then I just try to, like, continue the conversation and kind of diffuse her anger. And I'm like, your total is going to be like $5. Here's your Frappuccino. And I just hand it to her before she pays because I'm just trying to calm her down and give her her morning coffee. And she looks at me and she says, you're lucky you're semi-pretty because you obviously don't fucking have a brain, and throws the Frappuccino through the fucking window. First off, semi-pretty. Second off, I fucking graduated college 2 years early and am now modeling, bitch, so suck it.
So when I was 18 years old, I was working for Cracker Barrel. And I asked them if I could have Thanksgiving off because my aunt had cancer and I knew it was going to be one of my last holidays with her. And they told me no, that everyone was scheduled because it is one of their busiest days. So I did understand that, but I was like, okay, can I just work either a morning or a night shift, just not a double? That way I can make the hour drive home to either see them in the day or the night. And she was like, yeah, I'll see what I can do. Well, they scheduled me a double. So of course I worked it and I didn't get to see my aunt for Thanksgiving. And she did end up passing away a few days after Thanksgiving. But it gets worse. So because they make their schedule so far out in advance, I was actually scheduled to work the day of her funeral. And I told them that I wasn't going to be able to work that shift because I had a funeral to go to. And they said, okay, that's fine, no big deal. So while I'm at her funeral, I get a call from work. And I honestly shouldn't have even answered, but I went out and I answered. And they asked me where I was, and I was like, I'm at a funeral, like, I told you guys this, you said it was okay. And then they asked me how far away the funeral was, and I was like, that's weird, but I'm like, oh, I'm like an hour away back in my hometown. They told me if I didn't get there in the next hour, I was going to lose my job. So being young and dumb, I left the funeral right then and there and went to work. I was so mad and so mentally unstable that whole shift. The next day I went into work and I kind of just had a realization of everything and I'm like, why am I doing this? First off, serving jobs are too easy to come by. And I just sacrificed so much for this job for what? They obviously don't respect me. And that is the last time I will ever overextend myself for a job. You can always get a new job, but you can't always get time back.
Did I mess up by asking a coworker how his girlfriend's driving test went? Me and another coworker accidentally triggered one of our other coworkers. We have a small workplace / shop where everyone's business is constantly spread around. So a coworker of ours recently started dating a girl after splitting from his wife. This new girl was a few years younger than him and did not have a driver's license and was going to college. We would kind of tease him about driving his girlfriend everywhere. He was also somewhat reserved in speaking about his relationship, like intimacy. But he would laugh everything off. Anyways, he requested some time off to go take his girlfriend to do her driving test. Later in the afternoon, he came back to the shop, and when he walked in, I asked, "So, how did the test go?" And my other coworker said, "Yeah, did she pass it?" In response, he just looked at both of us in a confused way and angrily sprouted, "What the F?" He shook his head and said, "Why does everyone need to know all my business?" And then he went on and on about how nobody can have a personal life at this place. After his rant, he said, "It went all right. The doctor just gave her some cream and said that she will need to apply for a few weeks, and if I develop anything, I will too. But right now, I'm fine." Silence. I looked at my other coworker and he looked at me like, "What the?" Both of us cracked a smile, and then I looked back at him and said, "The driving test?" And his face went so red, he hurriedly said, "Oh yeah, she passed it," and quickly left. My other coworker and I busted out laughing. So this dude's girlfriend had picked up an STD from a different dude. Not long after that, everyone in the shop did know his business, but it was his own fault, right?
Story time about how my husband is bullying me into getting plastic surgery.
Disclaimer, this is not my story time. I repeat, this is not my story time. It was sent to me on Instagram. My husband and I have been married for 2 years. I'm in my early 20s and we just had a baby. We're really well off, thankfully, and we have a wonderful life. All things considered, I do have a wonderful husband. He loves me, always wants to be with me, loves our daughter, and is a wonderful dad to her. He's super caring and loves my family as well. The only problem is that he's addicted to Instagram. And he follows a lot of girls that, you know, look fake. One day he started showing me pictures of this one girl. I will not say who she is, but just know that she's a very big influencer who claims to be all natural and totally is not. He asked me if I wanted to get some work done after I had the baby. I told him no because that wasn't even a priority of mine. I was more worried about having our daughter and taking care of her when she was first born. That's when he suggested that I should do what Kylie Jenner did. Kylie Jenner supposedly had her baby and directly after she got her stuff done. I laughed off the idea and he said, "I'm serious." You see, I thought he was joking. I asked him why he wanted me to get that done. He confessed he was afraid that my body was gonna look completely different than when we first met. I was shocked because, I mean, you're in love with me, not with my body. After I had the baby, he made an appointment with me at a plastic surgeon. I had told him so many times that I did not want work done on me. I told him I wouldn't go to the appointment. Then he told me that he wanted me to look like the girls on Instagram, and that he needed my body to look like it did before the baby. I was shocked. My husband had never been like this before, but his addiction to Instagram was getting that bad. He pulled out his phone and started showing me pictures of girls on Instagram. I told him those were highly edited pictures, and he said, "I don't care." He told me that he probably wouldn't be attracted to me anymore, and that's why I needed to get all the work done on my body. I told him that I would never ask him to do anything surgical to his body for my benefit, and he told me that if I had asked him, he would do it in a heartbeat. Then he actually started showing me pictures of Kylie Jenner and Kim Kardashian. He told me that he knew who their doctor was and that I could go to that same doctor. I was more than shocked. I felt sick to my stomach. For those of you who may be wondering, my husband and his family own a very big company. He was born into money. For him, you can buy anything in the world. As the weeks passed by, he kept getting more irritated that I wouldn't say yes. One day, he showed me a picture of me that he edited of me to look like Kim Kardashian. My husband insisted that I look like Kim Kardashian. He actually even went ahead and edited a picture of me in the shape of Kim Kardashian. Disclaimer, this is not my story time. It was sent to me on Instagram. I started to cry instantly and I told him I did not want to get any surgery. He backed off because he knew he hurt my feelings, but just the following day, he asked me again. At this point, I didn't know how else to say no. A few days later, we were having a peaceful lunch and suddenly out of nowhere, he asked me what I would do if he found someone that did look like Kim Kardashian. I told him that I would straight up divorce him and that he would never see our daughter again. That's when he got up from the table and left. He basically gave me the silent treatment for 2 days. Finally, I told him that I would not get surgery, but that he could get me a personal trainer to work out. He said that that wasn't enough. Once again, he asked for me to consider it. 2 days ago when I got home, he ordered me a bunch of clothes from Skims. He asked me to try it on, and when I did, he said that I didn't look that bad, but that he still thought I should get some work done. He also told me I should get a tan. At this point, I just don't know what to do. I started a new diet in efforts to lose weight, and I'm working out my butt like crazy. I will never look like Kim Kardashian or Kylie Jenner, though. Should I just cave in and get the work done? Or should I just tell my husband no and suffer the consequences? I feel absolutely hopeless.
Disclaimer, this is not my story. I work on the weekends to assist a wedding photographer. It's good money and something extra from my normal job. I usually help organize people for photos and help manage all little tasks. After this one ceremony of a wedding that we had last week, I was organizing people for family photos, and the brother of the bride came up to me. I'll call him John, was saying how much he loves photography and how he thinks it's a beautiful art form. He started asking me all these questions about my job, which I don't mind, but I had to leave because dinner was starting and I had to sit at the vendor table to eat. The photographer decided that she wasn't going to eat because she wasn't feeling so well, so she was going to sit outside during dinner. So I sat there at the vendor table with the DJ and the wedding planner waiting to get our food. All of a sudden, I see John get up from the wedding party's table. He made his way over to me. He asked if he could sit with me at the table. So I said, sure. Then I start to realize he has a crush on me. So I tell him smoothly how I'm 17, a minor. So I would think that he would back off because he's about 22. But instead, he just keeps flirting with me. And it starts to make me feel really uncomfortable. So I say I need to get back to work. But then he just follows me. So I go outside to the photographer and I start putting my stuff in the car. And he's still following us like a puppy dog, saying I'm so pretty and so nice and he just wants to get to know me. And he asks for my phone number and I restate I am a minor. And I tell him I have a boyfriend and I'm just working. But he keeps pushing. So I take his phone and I give him a fake number. And lucky enough, there's no service at the wedding, so he can't make sure it's real. Finally, at this point, he leaves me alone. A week later, my photographer calls me and tells me that he kept begging her for my phone number. And he thinks that it was an accident that I put it in wrong. And he begging her for my phone number. And he thinks that it was an accident that I put it in wrong. And he really thinks we're soulmates and he has to see me again. And the whole bride's family is pushing her to give John my phone number. But luckily, she promised me she wouldn't. So am I the asshole for giving him a fake phone number?
Okay, so story time! We are back, besties! So my brother and his friends and his girlfriend was coming over, okay, right? Yeah, great. So they came by, everything was great, everyone was having a good time, hanging around by the pool, went to the beach, it was all amazing, yeah. So they were planning on going to a trip to Universal and I wanted to tag along, cause why not? So I did. We drove up to Orlando, which by the way, the top of the car almost fell off. We won't talk about it though. Anyways, we get to the hotel, we settled down and went to bed. So here comes the next morning. We wake up and get ready, my brother's friend, we'll call him Noah. Anyways, Noah forgot shoes. By that, I mean he brought slides. Which wasn't very smart because we're going to a park, but like, yeah. So we wake up early to go to Walmart and get him some. We also got my brother a shirt because he didn't bring any clothes. Which he brought a whole duffel bag, so I don't know. But anyways, we buy everything and we head to the park. Everything was great, we went on all the rides, we even went on Rip Ride Rocket. Like for part two. Okay, so part two. So we go on Rip Ride Rocket, everything was fine, we had lots of fun, almost crapped my pants, but that's beside the point. By the way, keep this in mind. When we went through security, my brother had placed the keys in the thing to check, you know? Yeah. And he grabbed them and he put it in his pocket. By the way, his girlfriend and I both had like a purse to carry stuff in, and he just decided not to give it to us, but you'll see, here comes the fun part. Anyway, so everything is great, we're all hyped because we went on Rip Ride Rocket, it was so much fun, and we were all excited. Then we get to the car. And you know what happens? So fun. My brother doesn't have the keys. So he doesn't have the keys. I don't have his keys. His girlfriend doesn't have the keys. And his friends don't have the keys either. So we're just stranded in the middle of Universal. Isn't that just so fun? So we checked to see in the car and he left it open. Which wasn't very smart because we had all our luggage in there. But you know, yeah, that's fine. But anyways, we checked and the keys aren't in the car. Like for part three. Okay, so part three. By the way, forgot to mention, this car is a rental. Anyways, we were supposed to leave the park around 3 because I had school the next day, and yeah. You know, we definitely didn't end up leaving till like 11-ish, and we live like 2 hours away. Well, we ended up calling some guy who works with keys. I totally forgot what it's called, but yeah. Oh, it's called a locksmith. We ended up calling a locksmith. The guy ended up having a spare key to the car, but when he was trying to hook it up, it just wasn't working. Well, this guy was kind of sketched because he was in a van and all, so it was just... yeah. So he kept telling us that his partner had an extra key that could work, but that we would have to follow him to where his partner is and do it over there. And like, none of us were trying to do that. Cause it was already sketchy enough. You know, stranger danger out here. Anyways, after a whole hour of arguing, he ended up just going to his partner and like another 3 hours passed by. We're waiting. Like for part four. Okay, so part four. So we end up waiting another 3 hours. He doesn't come back. His partner comes back. He manages to fix the car key, which, thank God. Everything's okay. We end up leaving around 11-ish, as I said before. We didn't get home till like 1, and I wasn't really trying to go to school, so I just didn't go. So the key is still lost during this time, and we're all trying to figure out what we're going to do with this rental, because I don't think we can return it with the new key. During all the fiasco, we did end up calling Universal to see if anyone has seen the key. They said they looked and no one had found it or no one has seen it. They told us they would let us know if anything showed up, which we just thought that they weren't going to keep on looking and nothing was going to happen. But a few days go by and they end up calling us back. They said that someone had found the keys and that they could mail it to our address. So we were stuck with the rental for a few more days, but at least we got the key back and the situation was fixed. More of the story, don't lose your keys. And lock your car, especially if you're going to parks.
My period blood and poop in her food because she was racist and homophobic. So I was in middle school and there was this girl, let's call her Isabella. Isabella was disruptive and one of the mean popular girls. I was pretty, so she was always nice to me, but not to others. I was quiet and kept to myself, so I didn't really have a lot of friends. One day, me and her were talking and she said the N-word comfortably. She said that a black girl in her class looked like a monkey and said sis is bald because she wears lace fronts all the time. She also said her lesbian friend is in love with her and it's disgusting, and that she was definitely burning in hell. I didn't say anything, but I didn't agree either. It made me extremely uncomfortable because I have friends who are black and I'm also a part of the LGBTQ+ community, and I have friends that are part of the LGBTQ+ community. So I came up with the perfect plan. I was going to invite her over to my house, get a couple of her secrets to spread around, and feed her something disgusting. So I ended up inviting her over to my house on Friday using the excuse I wanted to get to know her better. And she came an hour late. How rude. I heard the doorbell ring and you will not believe what happened next. Come back for part two. She ended up coming an hour late, which was annoying, but she said hi and brought some macaroni and cheese for later. It looks pretty good, I'm not gonna lie. So we decided to watch a movie in my room. It was on Netflix. She pointed out basically every single person of color and had a slur for them. I was so irritated. There was this one gay character too, and she said he was the F slur, and he was going to rot in hell, and how disgusting and abnormal he was. I just looked at her irritated. So after that, we started talking, and I got some secrets out of her. She told me she stole $500 from her mom and posed it on her brother. She told me she killed her cousin's goldfish one time out of spite. And she told me she was the one who spread rumors of her best friend being a slut. I asked for a zodiac sign and she was a Gemini. She was just horrible. So I told her to stay upstairs while I make her dish. I decided poop and period blood would be perfect for this. So while I was making her sauce for the tacos, I squeezed my tampon in her sauce.
This next part.
And I stuck my finger up her butt and swirled it in her sauce.
I'm sorry again.
After that, I set up her plate and called her downstairs. She said the food looked good and you will not believe what happened next. Come back for part three. I ended up mixing all that disgusting stuff in her food and I called her down to eat. She said that the food looked good, but the presentation could be better. I just gave her a smirk and said, yeah, you're totally right. So she sat down and I watched her eat the food. It was so funny and it was so satisfying. I ate some of her macaroni and cheese and I'm not gonna sit here in front. That shit was good. So after that, we talked some more. I didn't get any secrets out of her, but it was fine. I was satisfied. She left, and the next day at school, she wasn't there. A week later, she came back, and she explained her liver almost killed her. She said that my food practically poisoned her, but the doctors don't know why. I apologized, but I wasn't really sorry. Then I waited until a week, and I ended up exposing her secrets to the entire school. Nobody expected me to know so much or to even be a gossiper, but people were down with it. She ended up getting kicked out of the clique because her best friend now knows it was her who spread the rumors. And nobody likes her, and she's a loner. Karma's a bitch, for sure. Follow for more story times, and follow my Instagram as well. Check the links in my bio.